All right, guys, I'm at my last job of the day here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna finish out some carpet to some tile that's in a bathroom that just got redone. It looks really fancy, the bathroom does. Tile's brand new and the carpet is several years old. But some people have been commenting this morning, they were wanting to know how I fixed the tack strip. I was showing them that I used the 1/8 drill bit with a hammer drill. And I use these 1-inch ram set nails. I don't use a ram set because it's got too much power. Even with a small gauge 22 in it, it blasts the tack strip in two. It's a certain, I got really good with it, but still at some point in time, there's a certain amount of pressure you can push down on a ram set and have it work out. But most of the time you're off and you wind up blasting the tack strip in half, and then it makes the biggest damn mess. And the way people feel about guns these days, I wouldn't feel comfortable bringing a 22 in our house and blasting into concrete with it. And I damn sure wouldn't do it here because I'm right against some brand new tile. Let me show you. Got everything laid out here. Hang on. That's the bathroom. That's pretty fancy. I just had that put in. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm going to finish out. And I'm doing it the way you should do it. I hate when I encounter these and somebody's put Z-bar on them. That just absolutely pisses me off. So I'm gonna put this up here this way, and then I'm gonna finish it out, by cutting and tucking, and I'll show you. I'm gonna try to show all of this, or at least every step if I can. These nails will stay in there until I put my ram sets through. And then I'll take those out because the only time these guys really work well is when the house has been freshly built and the concrete is not quite cured. You can drive those in with ease. Most of the time when the house has been sitting around 10, 15 years or so, you try to drive them in and they'll either knock a chunk of concrete out or they'll bend over, or they rarely work. And also, I'm not swinging a hammer at those, being chancy that far away when I don't know what that nail's gonna do. I wanna do that. So I'm gonna try to set the camera up here and show some drilling and some nailing. So I'll be back. All right, I've got this set up to where hopefully I won't be in the way of the camera here. Without somebody here to film this, I'll have to work with me. Basically, the tack strip is gonna go just about, I don't know how to describe it to you. My finger, not that much of it will fit between the tile and the tack strip. So I don't know, basically about that much is what you're looking for right there. So this is what I'm gonna do in this particular area. And these guys are the nails that I use. These are 1-inch ram set nails, and the plastic piece is where they fit in the 22 gauge ram set, and then a pin fires it with a 22 gauge shell in it and blasts it into the concrete. I drill a 1/8 inch drill bit with a hammer drill into the concrete, and I take that little piece of plastic off, and that's what I drive in there, and this guy is not going anywhere. If you're gonna use, like I use the mini stressors to stretch carpet with, if you're over concrete and these nails aren't holding, you can put one of these in and you can move the house over a couple inches because these guys don't move. So here we go. Provided the drill bit is new enough and I'm not over something like a nail, we should be good. So let's see here. All right. Gives it an easy place to drive, and you don't have to swing so incredibly hard at it. You don't have to swing incredibly hard at it to drive it in. So. So let's take a closer look. There you go. That is, there's a little bit sticking over, but that's not a problem at all. So I'm gonna put another couple of them through. And basically you wanna try to, you wanna maintain, you see how the tech strip's getting off over here? You wanna pull it to where you need it everywhere and hold it and you drill the hole. And then when I get it all done, I'm gonna put probably about four of those in there. They hold a lot better than those tiny nails that come with it. So you don't need quite as many of them. If that deal is not gonna just fall out of there. You know, gravity is on its side, for one. Now, let's try this again. Bam. Try backwards now. All right, we're gonna hold it back a little bit with that particular nail, I believe. So I can find something different. That'll just about get it. Now, get that back out of there. Never used that before. Anyway, get that guy back out of there and we're good. Now, I'm gonna put one more of them in over here. Right about here. Yep, right about there. And then that'll be it for all I need to put in here. So I'm gonna put those in and I'm gonna take these nails out and I'll check back in here in a bit. All right, this here, where I'm gonna take the carpet, show you how I finish that out and get a pretty decent looking finish. Keep in mind, I had nobody to train me when I began this. I was a telephone guy coming into the field and had to figure all this out on my own. So I'm gonna show you what I do. We're gonna have to do it this way. Backwards here. Well, we can show a little bit of it right here. All right, tap it down in there. I'm gonna go ahead and finish doing that. That's basically how I begin. Let me go ahead and knock that out right quick, and then I'll probably show some of the cutting or something here as well. All right. What's giving me problems here is that the carpet has got a lot of mileage on it. And it's very soft and quilt-like. So generally you can hammer it in there and it'll stay, but what it's trying to do here is basically it's really trying to come back out of there. It's being difficult. I'm starting out with a fresh razor. Always starting out with a fresh razor. Now I'm gonna pull this back here. I guess we can see that just fine. Pull it right back to the edge. And since I'm gonna be stuffing it in there, you wanna leave a little bit long. You can always trim off. You can, how does it go? Measure twice, cut once, something of that nature. So basically we're gonna cut it about right here. So that's leaving it a little long. This is one of those things where you be careful every chance you get, because every mistake you make is something you gotta fix. It's gonna take you longer to get it done. I got the careful thing from being in the phone business. I used to install large phone systems, and I would spin down like 2,500 pair of telephone wire on a big mainframe inside the AT&T COs. It was Southwestern Bell at the time. And they had a color code that you would go on, and there was a tip and a ring on each one of them. And if one of them, it was 2,500 pair. So everyone had a tip and a ring. So there was 5,000 connections. If you miss one pin and you're off by one, everything has to be taken off and redone. So the guys that used to be really speedy with that, a lot of times would donate their weekends to come in and redoing all the work they did wrong during the week. So you're better off being careful. And this is not near as difficult to fix as what I just described. All right, I'm gonna finish this guy out here, and I will show when I get ready to tuck it in here. So see, we're coming apart here, and it's a little bit for me to stuff in. I'll show you how to do that too. All right. That ought to show basically how I'm gonna start. Sometimes you wind up doing this twice, once to get it in the first tuck in, and then once to get it in there a little tighter. This will probably be a two part. Over here, there's something funky going on. There's like almost concrete's missing under here. When I drilled through the concrete, I drilled and it punched through, and then there was nothing underneath it. So I don't know exactly what's going on there. Right now, basically to get even a tighter fit, I left it a little longer than I usually do. This is how I snug it in there. And then when you finish that up, basically you go along and you trim everything out of here you can and finish out the edges and stuff. So the more time you spend with it, the better results you'll have. And this older carpet is a lot of times more difficult to make look just beautiful. All right, so this is basically the gist of it all here. I'm gonna finish up with a little stuff like this right in here, tuck that in some more, then I've gotta take care of the edges over here and this little piece here and stuff like that. So that's basically the gist of how you finish out carpet to tile. No Z-bar, stuff's the devil. Hang on, let me turn the camera around. All right, that was how you finish up carpet to tile. Let me explain the dynamic on this job here. I went against my better judgment by doing this because I was sent over here by a contractor that never gave me his name until I got here, and I realized I was texting him, but he gave me the name of the resident here at the house that he was doing the job for. Only became knowledgeable of that when I got here. People were so nice, I wasn't going to not do it for them. But I recently had a contractor run and hide from me right after I finished like a $250 job. So I never got paid for that. And sometimes in your small business, you don't get paid. That's just part of the deal. Sometimes, you know, some people will work you and they never plan on paying you. So I've texted that guy several times since I've been here and I haven't heard back yet. He texted back very quickly the other times today when I contacted him about my arrival time. Only when I said I was coming over, he said, well, I'm not going to be there. So I went against my better judgment doing this, but I felt like it would make a really good video for one. And when I got here, I really liked the people. So that's why I did this. But the odds are I won't get paid for this because all of the red flags are there. So if you're presented with something like this, don't do it. Anyway, I just hope good karma's on my side and the video gets a bunch of views and it helps somebody somewhere in some other place, some other time. Thanks for watching, guys. God bless. And we're going to upload this, and I think I'm going to do a little straight talk video later tonight. Thanks for watching, and God bless.